With Bose and Sonos finally both releasing portable smart speakers, we wanted to give you a side-by-side look and listen and go over what features they have in common and what's different and hopefully help you make a decision on which one works best for you. Don't forget, both of these are available on app.com, so be sure to check them out in the links in the description after the video. These are both really high-quality speakers and it shows in what they offer. They'll both work with Google Assistant and Amazon Alexa, along with Apple's AirPlay 2, as long as you're on Wi-Fi. But they also both have Bluetooth built in for those occasions where you don't have access to Wi-Fi. And the batteries for both of them are pretty substantial considering all the features built in. Bose claims 12 hours on theirs and Sonos is 10. The Sonos, though, is a bigger speaker, and although neither one gives power numbers, it seems like the amps might be a little more powerful on that one, so it makes sense that their battery time's a little bit lower. Now, all that being said, it's unlikely either one's gonna last that full time, so realistically, I'd expect anywhere from 5 to 9 hours if you're using them at higher volumes or using the smart features along with the music. If you look at the designs, they're similar in the sense that they're both cylindrical shapes, but the Sonos is bigger and heavier. Bose comes in at 7.5 inches tall, a little over 4 inches in diameter, and it weighs just under 2.5 pounds. The Sonos is 9.5 inches tall, 6.25 inches wide, 5 inches deep, and it weighs a little over 6.5 pounds. Sonos has a handhold on the back and Bose has this rope style handle that goes across the top. So they're both easy to carry around your home or your yard, but I can see more people taking the Bose with them outside of those areas since it's lighter and the footprint is smaller. The Sonos, though, is actually capable of going more places. It's IP56 rated versus the Bose, which is IPX4. So while they can both withstand water splashes and even rain, you wouldn't necessarily want to take the Bose to the beach where you definitely could do that with the Sonos. They both sound great, though. Sonos, as I mentioned earlier, sounds a bit more powerful. It makes a little more bass, but I wouldn't say the difference there is enough to swing people one way or the other. And they both do allow you to make adjustments to their equalizers through the app, so you can kind of fine-tune them based on what you're listening to. Both are gonna have really crisp highs that allow you to hear tons of detail up top, and the mids do a great job of tying everything together. Here's a sound demo so you can get an idea of each one. The biggest difference I noticed as far as sound was concerned was the Sonos is very directional, meaning you have to be somewhere in front of the speaker for it to have its biggest impact. The Bose is a little different in that it's designed to give you 360-degree sound, so you can really hear it no matter where you're standing in the room. The Sonos does have one big advantage though. If you're on Wi-Fi, you can actually add another move to form a stereo pair, which gives you an even better experience. The soundstage gets way wider, and you can pick up even more details in your music. Bose, as of the filming of this video, doesn't allow that with the portable home speaker. The last small difference to note is the Sonos is about $50 higher in cost, however, it comes with a charging cradle. The Bose has a charging cradle option, but it's another $30, which makes them almost the same when you add that in. So the Sonos gives you the ability to create a stereo pair, it's more durable when it comes to IP ratings, and it has a slightly bigger sound on a single speaker. Bose is a few pounds lighter, has a longer battery life, and it sounds the same no matter what side you're standing on. Which one would you pick? Make sure to let us know in the comments. As always, we appreciate you checking out our video, and we'll see you in the next one.